What's up, guys? It's me, the Fanatic, and welcome to another live Pokemon Omega Ruby and Alpha Sapphire Wi-Fi battle. Today we are having an NU battle with a new team I made on Showdown. It's had relative success. It's also been completely destroyed. I've had some Wi-Fi battles of it earlier, got destroyed with it. Had a few battles with it earlier where I completely destroyed my opponent. So hopefully this game I'm having against StarDasher will be a lot closer and a lot more fun for you to watch and record and whatnot. I need to turn the game sound down just a bit so I can actually hear what I'm saying. What on earth is this, like, Twerkina? Oh, it's... okay, that's Twerky. I was like, who the hell's Twerkina? Right, there's Star, so let's just challenge him to a battle. So this is NU, and I'll quickly go over my team in the next screen bit, whatever, and see how my team fares against his. So I played Star the other day. I didn't really have a team. It was just mixed random things I had. This time I actually have a team, so hopefully I stand a chance. I believe he plays a lot of Showdown, so he should be quite a seasoned and good battler. So hopefully he accepts my challenge, if he wants to. Is he going to? Come on, Star, accept this challenge. You know you want to. You know you want to, buddy. Or you just want to ignore me. Alright, there you go, we found him. So, hopefully this goes better than my last one. My last battle. No, the last battle I actually won, like 4-0, so it wasn't too bad. Right, let's go with Battle Music 20. I haven't unlocked... I need to go do some Battle Maze on so I unlock the theme song from there, because it's quite a good theme song, actually. Let's go with Music 3, because it is my favourite. And I've only just realised up until now that with this Wi-Fi battle that I've been recording the music twice, so it sort of sounds like echo. So what we've got here, Zatu, Pyroar, Steelix, Sork, Seismitoad, and Vileplume. Okay, so it looks like Pyroar could come in handy here. I'm going to take a picture of his team, because I always forget to take a picture of teams, and it's really annoying. So let's quickly take a picture. My phone wants to hurry up. There you go. So that Steelix needs to be taken down ASAP. He's probably going to lead with the Zatu. However, I think I'm going to lead with Hariyama. And then, hopefully he doesn't lead with Seismitoad. I'm expecting he wants to lead with either Zatu or Steelix. Based on that, I'm assuming his Seismitoad might be an offensive Seismitoad. I have come across that. So good luck, Star. I'm looking forward to this battle. It should be good fun. So we have the awesome May music in the background. And I just want to see what his first Pokemon is, just to see if my Hariyama lead was good or not. I do have my... right, there's the Zatu. Okay, that's fine. I can fake out, but I'm also thinking I should probably just go for a knockoff, because he can't really... ooh, does this thing get trick? He could trick me something horrible. Let's go for a knockoff and see, shall we? Trick himself in Assault Vest Zatu. There you go, that's what we want to see. He obviously knows what this thing does, and he doesn't want to really touch me with this. So if he switches out, that's fine, as long as I can just get a knockoff on something. He'll probably go into Steelix, expecting this knockoff. But then, obviously, he can't really do anything because close combat and whatnot. So he withdraws like I thought he would, so it's a good job I didn't go for the fake out. Crow King. Let's go for the knockoff on this thing. That's fine. He obviously doesn't... maybe he wants to try and scald me. I don't know. And that's good. He's leftovers. It was a bulky one. So... oh, game, what are you doing? Okay, I thought it was going to disconnect there. That was scary. Let's go into my own Seismitoad, as we can't really touch each other. And we can do rocks for rocks and whatnot. Apart from his, has no lefty, so he can't recover his health unless he has Drain Punch. And even then, I have Mashana to stop him and then Scald and Earth Power and do much, and or Earthquake, whatever he has. Basically, Seismitoad is going to be a lot easier to take down. Plus, I have got my... what's it called? My Simi Sage. I should have probably gone into that. Should have gone into that expecting the Self Rocks. Never mind. I'll get my own rocks here. Oh, does he have a spinner or a defogger? I don't know if he does, because I don't. Game, please, let me... he might go into Zatu here. He might go into Zatu. So, I'm going to pull the double back into Hariyama, I think. So, am I faster, or has he just stayed in, and I could have got my rocks up? So we'll go back into Hariyama, please. Or he could even go for a Scald, if he wants. That'd be nice. Get the burn. Is he going to get... Please go into Zatu. He stays in. Oh, but I do get... Okay, yes. I like this. I like this a lot. I have got my guts boost now. And if Toxic becomes too much, well, then I can just do whatever the hell I want. So, let's go for the... Do I go for the fake out, or do I just close combat this thing to death? I say we close combat this thing to death. Oh, he switches out. What's he going to go into? If he goes into Zatu, I'll be annoyed. He does! Oh, I should have gone for the knockoff. Okay, never mind. Close combat is going to hurt. That does a lot of damage. That's done a lot of damage. Right then, I'm going to go into... if he wants to set up screens, that's fine. Because I do... Or do I just go for the knockoff? What's he going to do? I'm going to knock off. I don't think he'll be an offensive one. I don't think he'll have any offensive moves, will he? I don't know what Zatu's do. I don't even know if they're fast. I'd assume they're faster than the Hariyama. He might expect my switch. Oh, he goes for the psychic. Assault Vest, pull through, please. Assault Vest did not pull through. Oh, it's a crit! Ah, explains it. Okay. It's a Life Orb Zatu. Well, butter my rump and call me toast. What shall we do now? There's a multiple... There's like multiple different things I could do right now. I could HP Ice with Simi Sage, Dark Pulse with Pyro, Ice Punch with Electivire. Pyro needs to stay around for that Steelix. Alright, let's go with Evire. See what he wants to do. He might go into his Seismitoad, which is what I'm kind of expecting. So I'm just going to go for the Ice Punch. It should kill. But he'll probably just go straight into his Steelix. Because Steelix is a thing. And then I'll just get annoyed because Steelix is annoying and... But then Seismitoad's a pretty good counter for it, actually. Well, not counter. Check. I can just scald it to death and whatnot. Oh, come on. He's obviously deciding what it is. He's got two ground types, so... Alright, Ice Punch. He's going to just let this thing die. I can get my rocks up now. Finally. That's a dead Zatu. Now he does have a free switch, though. And, well, I'm sure Electivire is probably faster anyway. So it might not reveal that I'm scarfed yet. Expandong. Ah, there's Steelix. Okay. Straight into Seismitoad here. What could he have for Seismitoad? He'll have Rock Slide, Gyro Ball, Cursed, and Earthquake, maybe? So I'm pretty sure Seismitoad can take hits from this thing. Plus, I can burn it, so... What's he going to go for? What is this? What can this thing even do? I'm not sure. Earthquake. Yeah, it's not going to do much, is it? It shouldn't. Done more than I would have liked. So I have to go for a Scald here and hope I get the burn. Do I want the rocks or do I want the burn? Let's go for the Scald and hope for the burn. Is he going to want to stay in on that? I don't know. If he wants to go into Seismitoad, that's fine. I should have probably gone for the Earth Power to be safe. Oh, he does switch, and he'll be going into his Seismitoad right now. There it is. And I can Toxic him. He hasn't got leftovers anymore, so... Scald, Water Absorb, that's fine. I don't know what he can do to me. He might carry the knockoff, actually. That could be annoying. But now I can get my Rocks and my... Well, hopefully Toxic up. What's more important? Toxic... Or Stealth Rocks. Let's go for the Stealth Rock because I have got things to take this thing out. So let's go for my Stealth Rock, shall we? I'm not too worried by this thing yet. Yet. Toxic. Okay, he goes for Toxic on me, so that's fine. I have got a Cleric in my, what's it called? In Mashana, that's the one. I would like to see what he can do, though. It's my Krogunk. What's my Krogunk currently stopping on his team? What's he got on his team? Pretty sure he's a Pyro. But then Hyper Voice would probably take me out. So let's go for a Toxic of my own. Please hit. Please hit. Right. It's a Speed Tie. I hit my Toxic. That's fine. Sork. He could have gone into Steelix there, really. Expecting that. Or Vileplume, to be honest. Please take this Earth Power. We took it pretty well, actually. So now I can go into Mashana and Heal Bell. That's fine. He'll just try and he'll probably stay in and try and Toxic my Mashana. I mean, he's got two things that you could have switched in onto that toxic, but it's fine. I could... No, that Pyro is going to outspeed my Simisage, so I can't set up nasty plots with it yet. So let's go back into Mashana here. Well, let's go into Mashana, I should say. And then he withdraws, obviously expecting this. And does he go... What does he go into? Sork? No, Vileplume. Hey, that works for me. That works perfectly fine for me. Will he want to stay in? I do not know. He probably expected the Earth Power Scald or something. So what would he bring in on this? I don't know what he'd bring in. I'm going to yawn. Make him play the switches. He could go for the Sleep Powder here. Leech Seed, okay. That's a problem. That's a big problem indeed. Could have Psychicked this thing and done lots of damage, because they're normally physically bulky. But Seismitoad could... I think Seismitoad can always be physically or specially bulky. I think they have the same. And he's got a pretty decent HP stat, so... Do I Heal Bell? Do I Psychic? Do I what? So now he's got to either switch or... Oh, I've clicked Heal Bell now by accident, so... We're going with Heal Bell! Get rid of that poison off Seismitoad. And then hopefully I can play around with Water Absorb and get some health back. So let's Heal Bell, Expand Dong, he goes back into this thing, so I can threaten him out with a Yawn as well. Heal Bell, Bell Chimed, that's fine. So I wonder how much damage will this thing will do to me. He's got Leech Seed though, hasn't he? Do I sack off something? Do I yawn? Do I what? I think I'll go for a yawn this turn and then swap into Seismitoad. Probably. Earthquake, how much is this going to do? Sack off Seismitoad, probably. Okay. Decent amount. Hopefully he tries and kills me off on the next turn. Or will he switch? Oh, this is a risky play. I'm going to have to lose one of my walls, I think. None of my actual offensive Pokemon will appreciate an Earthquake from this thing. So is he going to want to let this thing stay in and go to sleep? Or is he going to want to switch? I assume he wants to stay in then. Is this thing slower than Mashana? Right, he does. He goes for the Iron Head. Okay, I should resist that. Yes! Okay, this thing... Whew, this thing, huh? That Steelix is now asleep. That's perfectly fine to me. Now, I'm not going to Scald, because Zatu's dead, and I can just freely Earth Power, can't I? So, let's do an Earth Power. Okay, he stays in. That's fine by me. You get the special defense drop. Ooh, wow, I've done a lot of damage. Crit, that's why. Revenge crit. For critting my Hariyama with that Psychic. Wait, Sleep Talk. It's a Sleep Talk Steelix. Rest, Sleep Talk, Steelix. Whatever floats your boat, then. Now, he could bring in Pyro here, couldn't he? Pyro's going to outspeed me. I'm just going to Energy Ball. I could Nasty Plot. I'm going to Energy Ball. Brings in Pyro, I'll be annoyed. Right, Energy Ball, finish this thing off. And it's dead, okay. So now the Pyro will come in, and I'm quite scared, because a lot of my walls are, like, screwed. We both have rocks up. This is a very tight game. This is such a tight game. Pyro. I like what you've done there, dude. Now, is he going to predict my switch? Has he got anything? He's got no reason to predict my switch, so I'm just going to go and sack off Mashana. Then I'll get a free switch into my... what's his face? My Electivire. But then, yeah, let's just sack off Mashana here. Let's find out if he's choiced or Life Orb. I'm hoping he's Life Orb. He could be choiced. What will he be choiced into, though? This could be a good game. If he's choice Scarf, this could be a good game. I'm hoping he's Specs. I really am hoping he Specs. What's he got left on his team? Sork, Vileplume. Sexy Toad. I'm gonna call it Sexy Toad because otherwise I just get it wrong all the time. I could Brick Break or Earthquake. What's the better choice here? Let's go for the Earthquake. He withdrew, so he's not scarfed. Crow King is coming in. That's fine. I didn't go for the electric move for that precise. Right, I need to keep Electivire. Electivire is going to be important. We've already discovered this. And then if I can keep my own Pyro around, that'd be nice too. I wonder if Electivire outspeeds that Sork. His Sork might be choice scarfed. Let's go into Simisage. And then I want him to bring, if he could bring in Vileplume, that'd be nice. Or would it? I don't know. As long as this thing goes down, I can then just start firing off wild charges and just do damage to things. Right, what are you going to go for? Earth Power? Should be able to take that, right? Should be able to take that. Yes, we do. Okay. We could go for a Nasty Plot. He might just end up going into Pyro, though. Then that's a problem. Do I focus? Will a Focus Blast kill from this range? He might even go into his, what's it called? Vileplume. Vileplume would be the safe play, wouldn't it? So I'm just going to Hidden Power Ice. He stays in. God damn. Stays in. Could have Nasty Plotted. Toxic. Oh, god damn. Okay, then. So he's going to be... Once this Crow King's gone, this is such a close battle. Simisage isn't as important to me anymore. I'm surprised he just wants to stay in with it. I'm going to Hidden Power Ice again because there's no reason for me to change move. It just lives. Oh, so close. Is he going to pull a switch into Vileplume? Is he going to save this? He does. Go into Vileplume. Go into Vileplume. He gets into Pyro. Why did I not Focus Blast? Stupid thing. Okay, I'm going to sack this off. Them Stealth Rocks, though. If I'd have Focus Blasted and hit. Never mind. Do I need to save Simisage? No. I have my own Pyro for that Vileplume. This is close. This is too close to call. Let's Focus Blast. He'll just go for the Overheat. Ah, brilliant. Okay, that's fine by me. Whatever he wants to do now, things are going to get wrecked. Have I got a safe switch in to Pyro? No, because that Sork is a thing. And he's just going to sack off... Right, he's going to sack off His what's it called? Toad thing. Right now. And bring in Sork to revenge kill. But the sooner Pyro goes... Oh, this is going to be so close. I think I might have just made a horrible misplay. Good Will-O-Wisp. No, he's going to sack off the thing. Right, so now I'm going to pull the double into Evire. Watch him swap into his... Oh, so I'm faster. Please swap into your Sexy Toad. I'm begging of you. Sack off your Toad. Overheat! He overheats again. That's not what I like to see. Oh, 1 HP. One tiny piece of HP. Let's lock myself into Earthquake then. And as long as that Sork isn't scarfed, I'm hoping it's banded. Ooh, what's he going to go into? Is he going to go into Toad now? He is going to go into the Toad. I thought he was going to go into the Toad the previous turn. That's frustrating. So frustrating. I can't switch. There's no point in me even trying. If this isn't a scarfed Sork, this is going to be so close. The way he brings it in makes me think it is. Too strong. Mold Breaker. Come on, please do not be Scarfed Sork. Please be banded. Oh, he's Scarfed Sork. Okay, that's good game, Star. That's a good game. I couldn't outspeed the Sork anyway at all. I need a Mashana for this thing. And I let it die too soon. I just let it die too soon. I enjoyed that battle, though. It was a really good tight battle. I mean, his Pyro is nearly dead. and he's just got this Sork. So it's like, it's a 2-0, but it's pretty close to a 1-0. Let's Hyper Voice. By some miracle, he misses. Good game, Star. I enjoyed that. But yeah, I think my team did alright. I just think I made some bad plays and he made some good plays. I shouldn't have pulled that double. I should have stayed in with Pyroar and taken that overheat. Although, I don't think it would have mattered because Sork could just clean up anyway. So I think he had that in the bag. I don't think there was any way I could have saved myself in that. Maybe if I somehow predicted a switch, if he switched into Sork and I got a Will-O-Wisp on him. Why are you running lefties on Simisage, by the way? I have no idea why I am, because I couldn't think of anything else better. That's a good question. Anyway, guys, hopefully you enjoyed this battle. I sure as hell did. If you did enjoy, leave a like. Subscribe if you aren't already. Otherwise, I'll see you next time. Goodbye.